My only question about Akil Glass and his productivity is going to be the offensive line that protects him. I think he has all the talent in the world, and I thought at one point he was the best quarterback in the SWAC last year. Just with his ability to push the ball down the field. Some of the struggles in the offensive line that showed up in the Grambling game last year kind of forced him into some mistakes. And in that Grambling game a year ago, he threw two pick sixes before they can even, you know, get their footing up under them. So as that offensive line goes, so will Akil Glass, but he has all the talent. Oh, yes, man. Brian Jenkins, small kid, little pack of dynamite. He talks it, but he walks it. He will make an impact in the receiving game. He will make an impact in the running game. He will make an impact on special teams. They even put him in to block a kick. He had an explosive run for a touchdown early on in the scrimmage. He just made a few dazzling moves. This kid is special. I think with enough touches and the ways that he's able to impact the ball game, I think that he can be a real SWAC offensive player of the year caliber player. So I like Brian Jenkins a lot. I saw a defense that flew around the ball. Taj Williams and Michael Edmonds, the linebackers, both sophomores, they really flew around the ball. Breon Austin, the worst number 92 on the defensive line, at times was unblockable. He made play after play in the run game, stuffing the run. That defense is flying around, which is a good thing. And if you're an Alabama A&M fan, A.J. Harris in the secondary, who's wearing number 5 this year, looks like he really took command of the secondary. He knew where everything was. He made some plays. And that's impressive considering this young man just transferred. His first time with his coaches was during the spring. I think the sky's the limit on the defensive side of the ball. If there were some areas of concern, it is that the secondary will oftentimes get lost on the deep ball. That's something that's going to happen. Secondary play, you teach defensive backs to have a short memory. But if there is an area of concern, sometimes the defensive backs were beaten on the one-on-one plays, especially on the outside.
It's just consistency. With a new defense, is learning that system, not trying to do too much stuff right now because it's a new system so the guys can play fast. Offensively, just tuning stuff up. We got a lot of guys returning from last year's team on offense, so we want to play fast and tune stuff up and execute at a high level.
This football team has a lot of energy. This program has a lot of energy. I've been around the A&M program for a few years now, and I will say this. There has not been this type of energy at a spring game at Alabama A&M in a long time. And I'm talking about since before 2012. This program, these kids, they play with a lot of energy. They play with a lot of enthusiasm, and that's something that's big. This team only has 9 seniors listed. So this is a young football team. They come back with a lot of returning starters, but this is a young football team. And I think that Coach Maynard is building something special. A&M, of course, Alcorn is the big dog in the East. And A&M played Alcorn okay last year. They got within a score a few times. I'm not sure if they're ready to take that step to dethrone Alcorn yet, but they're close. They're getting closer and they're getting closer. So I think overall, I think you'll see an improved team. And I think they'll build off of that 6-5 record a year ago.